As they were sitting at the table prior to making a move upstairs, Andrew Crowther took from his waistcoat pocket a small glass bottle. He unscrewed the cap and shook out onto the table four or five little white pills. Evidently more had come out than he required, for he set the bottle up on end, and picking up all but one, he dropped them back into it. Then screwing on the cap, he replaced the bottle in his pocket. Finally, he swallowed the remaining pill. Charles had not been particularly interested in the operation, and though he absent-mindedly watched the old man, he made no remark upon it. He could see from the name on the bottle that the pills were a well-known patent remedy for indigestion, evidently that to which his aunt had referred on his last visit. Andrew touched the bell at his hand, and Weatherup appearing, the old man was helped up to his study. Charles followed, Weatherup withdrew, and the great interview was launched. Charles began by repeating a good deal of what he had said at their previous meeting. Then he went on to explain that he wanted his uncle to look at the actual figures in question so that he might see for himself the seriousness of the position. He brought out his ledger and explained it. Finally, he made the strongest appeal of which he was capable for an advance on his legacy. He stated his case well. To himself it sounded unanswerable, and as he talked he felt a growing confidence that this time his request would be granted. It came upon him, therefore, as all the greater shock, when at last it was driven in upon him that Andrew Crowther did not intend to do anything of the kind. The old man hummed and hawed, and mumbled puerilely about Charles working harder, and thus wresting orders from his slacker competitors. He could not envisage conditions being any degree different from those to which he himself had been accustomed.